on optical fiber, the bending loss here. So we have seen the previous the transmission characteristics before three videos, and so in which we have seen the details of how the attenuation is been calculated due to the absorptions and the scattering losses here. So these are the learning outcomes. At end of this session, students will be able to estimate the losses due to the bending of a optical fiber here. So up till now, what we have seen is the losses due to the absorption in the ultraviolet region and the infrared region, and in which we have seen the eccentric and the incentric losses and the scattering losses in the linear and the non-linear scattering losses here. In the linear, we have seen the Rayleigh's and the Mie scattering, and we have seen how to calculate the Rayleigh scattering here. And one more thing we have studied is that there is a non-linear scattering in which we have seen the stimulated Raman scattering as well as the beryllium scattering here. So before starting to this lecture, so just recall, so what is the difference between the single mode fiber and the multi-mode fiber here? Because while solving this, the bending loss for the optical fiber, we should know that the difference between the single mode and the multi-mode here. So the single mode is nothing but only the fundamental mode is going to be transmitted from the transmitter to the receiver side. And in the multi-mode, that is one more than one fundamental modes are being transmitted here. So that is known as the multi-mode here. So for how you can understand, that is the core diameter of the single mode is about 2 micrometers to 6 micrometers or 10 micrometers only. For multi-mode, the core diameter is that is 25 micrometers, 50 micrometers, 62 micrometers, as well as the 125 micrometers. Means it is a larger in core diameter here. That's why. So we should understand this. So now we'll start with the bending losses. That is, depending on the radius of the bend, there are the two types of bends here. That is a micro bend and the micro bending. So the micro bend, as shown in this figure, it is the imperfections of the layer, as overlapping of the core and cladding will be there. There is some micro bends will be there. You know that that whenever the light is going to be transmitted into the core, so it should follow the total internal reflection. That light should not get transmitted to the cladding, because otherwise the data will be lost here. So due to the micro bend here, the light at the hit at this micro bend will come out from the into the cladding here, and the data will be lost here. So such type of thing is known as the micro bend. If you want to completely remove these losses here, then we have to remanufacturing the optical fiber. That is, the core and cladding should be made once again here. In the micro bend, that is, we have seen that it is the bend because due to the radius of curvature is larger than the core radius here. That is the core diameter here. So such type of things are known as the micro bend here. So as shown in this figure, you know that the light is traveling inside this core here. So it is incident here and it comes out to be in the cladding here. So that's why there is a loss of data here. Some light may pass through it, but all light should follow the total internal reflection here. So there is a slightly difference between the micro bend and the micro bend here now. So if you want to calculate the bending losses for the multi-mode and the single mode, then there is a different formulas are used for that. That is RC M, that is known as a 3N1 square into lambda, that is lambda is the operating wavelength, and 4 pi into N1 minus N2 square, that is a refractive index difference raised to 3 by 2. And the second one is the critical radius for the curvature, that is the RCS, that is for the single mode fiber, which is given as 20 lambda by 1 N1 upon N2 3 by 2. That is 2.7 into 48 minus 0.996 lambda by lambda c. That is the operating wavelength as well as the cutoff wavelength is there, and raised to minus 3 here. So now we'll solve one example on the bending losses, how to calculate the critical radius for the single mode as well as the multi mode here now. So as shown in this example, there is a step index is given here. Step index is nothing but the core of the step index is uniform, refractive index is uniform, and the graded index, that is not uniform here. So for example, we have taken the two step index fiber, and there are two cases, that is case A and case B. For multimode fiber, the refractive index is 1.5, that is core refractive index means N1, that is 1.5 it is given. And the relative refractive index difference is given, that is a 3% here. Means they have not given N2 here. So we have to calculate that, and the operating wavelength is 0.82 micrometer. And in the second case, we have seen that 8 micrometer core diameter, that is a single mode fiber with a core refractive index same as, and this means N1 is taken as N1.5, and the relative difference refractive index, that is the delta, which is given as an 0.3% here, and operating wavelength is given as an 1.55 micrometer here. So we have to estimate the critical radius for the curvature, which is large bending loss occurs in the both the cases, in the large bending losses here. So for RCM, we should know that it is calculated N1 square lambda, that is 4 pi N1 square minus N2 square 3 by 2. So now we'll put all these values into this equation, and we'll see that how much comes to when critical radius for the RCM. So before that, we should know that how to calculate an N2. So the refractive index of an N2 is calculated in various manner. As now they have given the relative refractive index as a 3% less, and N1 is given as an 1.55. So for that, we need to understand how to it is calculated. So it is calculated, that is delta N1 square upon N2 square, 2N1 square here. So we'll substitute all the values, 1.5 and N2 square upon 2 into 1.5 square, that is 3%, that is an delta here. So now if we calculate this, it comes to when N1 square 2 delta N1 square here. So which comes to be 2506 into 2.25, that is 2.115 here. So we'll substitute these values into RCM, that is 3N1 square into lambda 4 pi N1 square 3.2. So we'll substitute 3 into 2.25% to 0.82 tenders to 6, that is micrometer, 4 pi. If you calculate N1 minus N1 square minus N2 square, it comes to be 0.135 half. So which comes to be 9 micrometer, which comes to be 9. So for the critical radius for the multimode comes to be 9 micrometer here. So we have substituted the values, and directly we have solved for this here. So the case one has been solved here. It comes to when RCM comes to when 9 micrometer here. So now for the case B, so which is the core refractive index is taken as in same, that is one, and the delta refractive index is 0.3%, and difference is there, and operating wavelength. In the same manner, we have to calculate for the N2. So we need to calculate for this. Okay. So for case B, so we will solve this. So which comes to be 2.250 into 0.006 into 2.250, which comes to be 2.237. Okay. So now there is one more thing, that is the cutoff wavelength has to be calculated, that is cutoff wavelength for the single mode fiber, that is lambda c, which is calculated 2 pi a n1 2 delta half upon 2.4, because for single mode it should be less than, v number should be less than 2.405. A is the refractive, means N1 is the refractive index, and A is the core radius. So that's why it is given as an 8 micrometer core diameter, it is given here. So we'll calculate, that is, it is diameter, so you have to take as an half into 1.5. Refractive index relative is given as 3%, 0.3%, which comes to 0.06 upon 2.45. So it comes to when 1.24 micrometer. So this value has to be substituted in the equation,
in equation of RCS. So for RCS, which is given, now we will solve on next page. So which is given as an RC equals to 20 lambda N1 minus N2 3 by 2, that is 2.748 minus 0.996 lambda upon lambda C, where just now we have calculated this raised to minus 3. So we'll substitute this 2 into 1.55 micrometers, that is 10 raised to minus 6. Here 0.043 half, 2.48.96 into 1.5 into minus 6 upon 1.24, which is been calculated minus 6, which comes has to be 34 millimeter. Millimeter. Okay, so this is my, for a single mode it is 9 micrometer, for RCS 34 millimeter here. So so from this example, so we can understand that the critical radius for the curvature for guided modes can be made extremely small, that is guided mode for it can be 9 micrometers it can be made. And although this may be a conflict with the preferred design and the operational characteristics, so in this manner we are going to calculate the RCS and RCM here. Okay. So these are my references. Thank you.